Hello and welcome to the second interview for election May 2020 here on WolvHaven. Today we're joined by Quirtzy from People's Party of WolvHaven, also known as PPW. Hello, Quirtzy.
Hi there, Matt.
Why don't you go ahead and present yourself pretty quickly?
Well, I'm Quirtzy, leader of the People's Party of WolvHaven. I'm here to talk about what our party will do and what we're planning to do, and
This question might come across as a bit mean, but your two party founders, shall we say, you and Cube, have only been on the server for about 2 months, and you're up against much more established political parties. Do you find this a challenge or an alternative that WolvHavens can choose?
I do see that as a challenge because, of course, they will have a lot more experience in WolvHaven politics and the server overall. I do also believe that newer to the server should also have the chance to participate in Parliament. So, me myself, liking politics, I decided to join up, make my own party, participate and see what it's all about.
Now let's go on to your manifesto. There's two big policy points that you start off with. The first one, our policy is simple, quote, you say, we do. We aim to deliver the things you want to see in our community. Obviously, this brings up a contradiction. What happens if your supporters want something that is contradictory to the specifics in your manifesto? What do you do about that?
Well, of course, many things will obviously have to be done for a bill or a movement. So, of course, that will have to be voted on anyways. So it won't always pass. However, for the people that go against our manifesto, we try to show that some things that they want to see in WolvHaven will just not fit there. And we'll try to explain that and hope they will understand. And we'll try to show them that they're basically wrong.
For your second main policy, in which you quote the saying, keep your friends close, but your enemies closer, you aim to communicate with your opposition, which is something interesting for WolvHaven because it's deeply polarized currently between two parties. So you aim to have a sense of... do you aim to be a sensible third option for WolvHaveners to choose?
Yes, indeed. We don't really want to make an enemy parliament. We want to keep everyone united. So we don't really want to go against a party. I believe personally that we should all be viewed as equal opportunities to be voted on. Yeah, I don't really see trying to make an opposition. I prefer making friends in Parliament and stay together.
I kind of cut you off. Continuing on with that topic, will you be open to, if you are elected into Parliament, obviously, are you open to joining a coalition with another party or? A confidence and supply agreement, for example?
I did get an offer to join a coalition. However, right now I'm not interested in joining a coalition. So while I do see that as an option in the future, right now, I'm not seeing a coalition being...
Okay, let's move on to your what you call milestones in your manifesto. Let's move on to the first point, an improved punishment system. You want to simplify the appeal system? That's what I understand with it?
Yes, that's pretty much the point. Just basically simplify it. Yeah.
So why do you think there's a problem with the current appeal system?
Many players who are given an official warning might not be always aware that they can actually appeal to the warning. So we basically want to simplify that and make them aware that there is a choice to appeal And we want to make that official via, preferably, like I mentioned in the point, something like Google Forms, like many other applications that you could apply for in Wolf.
Moving on to your second point, or second milestone, rather, encouragement for application to roles. What does this concretely mean? It mentions an application for roles with skills, so...
Basically, some players, they have great talents, but firstly, what I've seen for the first few months I've been here is that not many have actually considered them applying for architects or engineers. So basically, we just want to encourage that. And well, if you've got great redstone or building skills, then basically we're encouraging you to apply for those roles. Because you could be a great benefit to the community, and yeah.
So policy-wise, what would that mean? Like, in terms of a parliamentary bill or something like that? Or a motion?
I'm not really sure. I haven't... this isn't really one of our main strong points that we've planned, so it's definitely up for more talks within my party. So we are still thinking how we could expand on that policy.
Okay. Let's move on to infrastructure change. Step three, big thing to certain members of the WolvHaven community who really do enjoy a step three station. And then you also mentioned the diversification of the transport system of WolvHaven. So you mentioned boats or buses. Why are you planning that?
Basically the thing I've seen in WolvHaven is that we mainly have just buses and the metro. We've of course got the tram lines, but To comparison with the metro, it's a quite small tram system. So with Wolves in WolvHaven, it really gives us options on what types of transport we could do. So basically, I want to diversify the transport system to appeal to all kinds of players, not just to the so-called railtards. train / metro enthusiasts. So yeah, we also want to appeal to people who like boats or trams, things like that. So we do really want to diversify that.
Okay, we're just going to cut through a really short commercial break. Stay with us here on Usenet. Thank you. Welcome back. We're still with Quirtzy from the People's Party of WolvHaven. We're going to continue on with his manifesto in the milestone section. This is the fourth point, I believe. Stability and assurance in the government. You state that we, quote, claim to ensure, we aim to ensure the government is up to its highest manners while we are in it. Whilst in government, we will follow the rules. So basically, you're just saying that we will keep a high standard if we are elected. That's my interpretation, at least.
Yeah, that's a part of it. Well, from what I've witnessed while on WolvHaven, is that the government can be sometimes quite feisty, quite not nice, quite rude. So basically, our party just wants to ensure that the rules are followed. So, for example, there are no ad hominem attacks, yeah, personal attacks. So that's kind of what we're trying to say with that.
Your next point, Gardelia reforms and staff improvements. So I'm going to split this in two. Your idea is to make tutorial videos for Gardelia building and world edit applications. I personally think this is a good idea, but who would handle this? Who would make the videos?
Basically, with the announcement that... sorry, I apologize. I have to check this again. With the announcement that WBC is now in the interest of making videos and movies, we think that that might be to great use to making these tutorial videos. So, we feel that cooperation from WBC or even Usenet will be needed to make this. While it will require some work, we believe it can be done.
You also mentioned at the last sentence of that paragraph, quote, our plans for this make sure no additional staff requirement is needed as our helpful staff have already a lot on their hands. What do you mean by this?
Well, basically, with many of our points in the manifesto, it may seem that a lot of staff work may be needed, and already with some real life stuff like COVID, we just want to make sure that everyone knows that we will not put any strain on staff, as the past few parliaments meetings have been quite keen on lowering the amount of staff, the amount of work staff are working on, and that's still something we want to keep doing.
Moving on to your last point, shop offers in WolvHaven to franchise owners. What does this concretely mean? You mentioned creating ads for state-owned malls and a reminder that shop spaces are still available. Concretely, what does this mean?
If I can correctly recall, in WolvHaven, there's still a lot of unclaimed shop spaces, and now with the job plugin removed, many players are seeking the opportunity to start a franchise or a shop. So we just want to make them aware that there's still many spaces where you can place your shops and make them. And with that, that will greatly also improve the economy of WolvHaven, as with every purchase, some money goes to the government and to the tax account, and it will be a low, steady flow to deflate the economy and make it better.
We've run through your manifesto and we still have quite a bit of time. Is there anything else you'd like to discuss?
I could ask the same thing. Is there anything else you're interested in or would like to know about us?
I'm sure the party logo has amused quite a few of us. If you could explain the idea behind it.
Basically, the logo is I mean, it does have a meaning behind it. It's two people holding hands in unity and agreement. So yeah, it's two hands shaking together in an agreement. Yeah, and unity. So that's kind of the idea behind the logo. And many people have been comparing our party to a communist party, which, well, took me from surprise, which quite, well, surprised me. But I must admit that the idea behind our logo was actually from a logo of a communist party. So the logo is quite... took many people by surprise, but I just want to clarify that out.
I think it must be the color, the red color as well, that kind of leads to some confusion. Do you have a last word for people watching us?
Vote PPW, we'll make WolvHaven great together.
Thanks very much, Quirtzy, for joining us. Yeah. Well, we hope you'll come back soon, and as well to our debate later this week.